please?
Yeah. Now
Yes,
you
now
see
we are
one
done.
only?
Great. Perfect. Go ahead.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Erika Bosani, and I work in Whirlpool in a central department, Operation Excellence, that is the industrial engineering, central industrial engineering, coordinating all the factories for Whirlpool EMEA. In Whirlpool, since a long time, I had an experience of project management. And currently, I am the research and development project manager working within the European project, in particular way focused on the Horizon 2020 and IT manufacturing, collaborating also with Nadia, presented the project before. This afternoon, I want to speak to you about the Koala project, that is a project developed within H2020 program that is focused on the creation of a digital assistant in order to support the workforce in manufacturing companies. The project is a funded project, 3 years duration, started last year in October, and put together a relevant consortium of partners. Here, as you see, in a glance, which are the partners that are contributing and collaborating with us. You may see here both university research centers and subject matter experts. And we, with the Diversi and Fratelli Piacenza, are inside the consortium and play the role of the industrial end users, so to validate the solution that will be developed by the Koala project. The vision and the idea that is driving the Koala development is really the possibility to use artificial intelligence in order to create an effective support for workers at shop floor. And the idea is really to develop a solution that is really interacting with a human-like effect with the persons at shop floor in order to facilitate their operation, in order also to allow them to leverage on all the knowledge that the digital systems and the digital technologies introduced in our factory are able to create and to provide to them, in order really not to replace the human being at shop floor, but to create something that may proactively support their activity in order to put them at the center of the development of the technology. And this is really one of the key elements that make this project so interesting for us in particular. The solution that will be developed is really a cognitive assistance that will be able to interact with the operators at shop floor in order, first of all, to support them in executing the activities, suggesting the task that they have to execute, and supporting with information, with recommendation, with suggestions, also the elements that may facilitate and may improve the quality that they have in executing their task. Consider that in particular way, the digital assistant will be able to leverage on a data analytics, AI solutions, and the AI technologies that will provide a support for picking up, make easier the learning process of the trainer, of the workers for the new activities, or maybe able to support them in executing complex tasks that currently are not allowed for them, because they implies analytics activities that are not consistent, are not compliant with the daily and working activity at the shop. So the idea is really to create a solution that will be able to interact like humans to humans in order to improve their life. I don't want to enter in many details in the architectural structure of the solution, but one of the key elements that I want to highlight here is that the key objectives that the project has are summarized here in these four elements, the color four elements that you see, that are fundamentally representing the improvement of the overall quality of the tasks executed by humans that may be supported and granted by the introduction of this type of digital assistant at the floor, and also the speed up of the training time that is needed by the person and workers in order to learn the complex tasks that they are required to execute. For sure, the idea is also to use Koala, and this is absolutely relevant for us, for Whirlpool in particular, but I think also for the other industrial companies. It's a way for us to overcome the barriers and the skepticism that the most part of the workers have when we introduce a shop floor AI solution. And we live every day is this type of situation, because most part of the time there is the belief of the person that the new technologies will replace. So we want to use Koala in order to prove that the introduction of this type of technology will empower people, not replace people in acting in order to achieve the business objective. And last but not least, we wanted to, and the objective of Koala is really to improve the possibility and the knowledge and the capability to use the knowledge by the workers. Knowledge that is transformed in a digital way and available to anybody that can need. And this is something that for sure overcome the current constraint that most part of the time limit the knowledge to the experience of the person. So more very in a very difficult way may be shared among the colleagues working in the same area. For sure, I don't enter in the detail on how we will reach this objective, but for sure the two elements outcome of the project that we expect to achieve once we complete the project development will be for sure a strong improvement of the performance at the shop floor, so in production and in particular way in terms of product quality, in terms of process quality. And the second one, but not less important, is a strong improvement in the possibility to integrate people into the digital ecosystem, because currently there are some barriers that if without a strong change management action affect the possibility to introduce in a sustainable way the new digital technology at shop floor. In order to, without entering the detail of the system architecture, what I want to highlight is that the key elements of the system solution is based on these six loops that you may see colored here that represent the possibility of the digital assistant to collaborate and integrate and communicate in an integrated way with the assets. And in particular way, we consider assets, both workers and machines, but in a more extended way, also products and the factory ecosystem. And the idea is really to have a module and components that may create a proactive and effective communication channel that allow the transformation of the speech to text and text to speech solution, and providing with these four modules that you see here, so the advice, the predict, inform and explain, all the functionalities that may support the workers at shop. Integrating really and all the data available, leveraging on this type of data availability and leveraging on the AI technology implemented. The idea that is behind is really to be able to increase the agility, so the possibility of the person also to change their job because they may be supported in changing the workplace and learning in a fast way the new tasks, and also increase the quality of the manufacturing process that they are taking because the support is effective. For sure, last but not least, we leverage on through the explain module the possibility really to make the AI solution affordable for and to overcome the barriers. The project will be focused fundamentally on three business cases, one for Piacenza, one for the diversity that fundamentally focused on the training context, and the last one for us, for Whirlpool, that is focused on quality, in particular on predictive quality. So the idea that is behind the two use cases for the diversity in Piacenza are focused on the cognitive assistant for on-the-job training. So the idea is that the digital assistant will support the workers in order to be trained in operating in complex machinery. And so providing advice, suggestion, recommendation, and lead the operators through the tasks execution in order to speed up the learning. For what concerns the Whirlpool use case is focused on the contrary on quality, predictive quality concept. And the idea is that the digital assistant will support the operators in the quality control, and in particular way will support the operators providing a predictive quality information to proper adjust the quality checklist dynamically according to an AI technology applied on data. Currently, which is the situation for quality control, we have for sure no support for the operators, the checklist are fixed, and for what concerns the training on the job is something that is done only through a supervisor control. So we need as part of the time, we have a bottleneck in the resources in the shop floor because some person have to support the trainee while they are learning the task. So I will focus the attention in particular on our use cases, so the one focused on quality control. The use case will be focused on the ZHT lab, so zero-hour test. We consider the zero-hour test is a statistical quality control that is done at the end of the production line, our production line, by operators. Currently, the checklist is fixed, is defined once the product is designed, and cannot be changed by the operator. And everything is in the head of the operator, and the operator has no support in order to, on top of the white paper that describes the steps that have to be. Koala will develop some scenarios, some functionalities, both for the laboratory operator and for the supervisor of the laboratory. And in particular way, what I want to focus is that they will develop new functionalities that currently are not available. So the idea that is behind is really to leverage on the digital assistant creation in order to provide something that currently is not available for the person that may change and improve their life, that their daily life. In order to give to you an idea, this is really a description of the scenario. So for example, currently, there is, for example, in Koala, a user identification. So this means that in Koala, the user identifies himself. So we have the possibility to understand and to support personally communication with specific individual. And Koala is able to learn and to tune the communication mode using a particular language, a particular tone, a particular way to communicate, a level of detail, depending from the experience of the person, while currently there is no identification of the person because there is no data system on top of the one that collected the defect that is able to interact with the operator. When the checklist is executing, currently the operator fundamentally has the checklist in his head. And so there is no support on top of the paper that drive the operator in order to ensure that all the steps of the checklist are executed. Koala will lead the person step by step, asking and communicating with him or with her, and providing all the information that are required in order to properly execute the test, and defining also the level of detail depending from the experience of the person. The communication will be very active, and the Koala will be able to learn depending also from the feedback that the operator will provide to the system itself. when a defect in this laboratory is identified, currently the data are entered manually into the data collection system, while in the future Koala will support a data entry that pass through the assistant. So the voice control may allow the operator to enter directly into to integrate all the legacy systems that we have in our protection. Another important element that currently is not existing at all is the recommendation management. So Koala, through the artificial intelligence and data analytics applied on all available data in Google Cloud related to quality and the fact that are connected to the specific SKU, so the specific product that is under control, may suggest, identify some quality risk and suggest additional quality verification, so steps in the checklist, in order to capture potential non-quality that we may have on the product. So this means that also the operator may execute the quality control is in a more effective. The same is for the information request. Currently, in order to retrieve the information, the operator has to get access into different systems, silos systems, functional systems, and so on. Spend a lot of time in retrieving the information that are needed in order to verify the quality compliance of a product towards the standard. In the future, Koala will provide automatically this information, integrating all the available data and providing only with the voice control request this information to the operator. Last but not least, Koala will provide a support that currently is not existing for root cause analysis. So the operator will be empowered and will be able to navigate into the data lake in order to support a root cause analysis when a defect is identified. Currently, this activity can be done only out of line, let me say in is an event or in project focused actions that have to be set up. In the future, they will be executed directly within the work cycle process because the person can get access to this type of information. So can create a knowledge related to what they are discovering and what other people have discovered before. There is also, and this is something that is absolutely new for us, some functionalities that are dedicated to the lab supervisor. So currently the lab supervisor has to manage only manually, not only the activity of the supervision of the activity of his own operators, but also their competence development. In the future, Koala will provide with a vocal interface also in his case, the possibility to have functionalities supporting the operator's competence development, the training for them, and supervising the quality data evolution, supervising also the quality control process that will be improved through the recommendation and through the predictive approach to quality that Koala will be able to implement. Currently, we are in the design phase, so we are just at the beginning. A lot of expectations, you may imagine, are behind this project for us, and for sure a lot of challenging and risks that are related to the development of this type of solution for us. Risks that for sure are technical, and here fundamentally are focused on the risk to have a poor communication, like most part of the chatbot that currently are implemented and everybody experience everywhere. Most part of the time, the chatbot are very poor, so the level of communication and the richness in natural language with the person is not enough to create a satisfaction in the user journey, and the end user experience. Unfortunately, this is one of the key challenges that Koala will face, because without a good communication solution for the assistant, for sure we cannot expect that we can introduce a digital assistance to workers at short. Another important element is related to the operational. That is something that is not specifically
only due to Koala solution, but it's more widely related to the introduction of AI technology at shop floor. So the risk there is really to have a loss in the competence of the person, because there is the person delegate fully the intelligence to the machine, so to the machine and to the artificial intelligence. This is a risk that we have, and this is something that for sure has to be compensated and mitigated by training and by organizational actions. Another important element related to human aspects, and in particular way, the risk to have invasive tool that are used at shop floor that most part of the time create reaction in the person. Because for sure a digital assistant listen all the words that the person is saying and has to be able to distinguish what is relevant for the quality management purpose from the rest that is related to real life or normal life of the workers that is covered by privacy. And here I connect immediately to the other important challenge that is related to the sensitive data management, because the usage of digital assistant and shop floor means that we have to be strongly compliant to the digital requirements. And so we need to implement a full anonymization of the data that has a strong impact also on the organizational setup of the solution. And last but not least is that it's important that this type of solution, digital assistant, are able to distinguish what is relevant to the objective of the solution implementation and what is not relevant, because the recording of the conversation of the person is something that has to be treated with a lot of attention, in particular way to be compliant with the laws and regulations and so on. So for sure for us, in order really to close, Koala experience is very important because it represents from one side our vision of the future of our workers. We think the application of artificial intelligence in the future like something that really supports the person and facilitates the life of the person, improving their capability to leverage on a digital knowledge that can be created and shared, and improving their capability to have a good result in terms of business objectives. This is something that we will test into the Koala project, and we will leverage on this experience in order really to verify if this will be the right way to proceed in the digital transition. I have to remark in particular way that for Whirlpool, the experience of the research project has been and is currently very important, because it is for us a way to start the change management, the change of the mindset, and to experience this new technology at shop floors in our factories, to create an awareness that allow us to initiate the digital transformation in the implementation of this technology. That's all from my side. I don't know if there are questions.
Thanks a lot, Enrica, for staying with us till this late afternoon. Thanks a lot. It was amazing, informative. So now it's time for questions. I know you are all tired, guys. It was a difficult day. Till now, we pulled it. But if you have questions, please feel free to ask.
Otherwise, you may get in touch directly with me via LinkedIn or via mail. You have my reference.
Now we have a question. I'm just activating your camera and voice as well, other participants, so that in this last moment of the day, you can switch on your camera and mic and ask directly Enrica to make it more interactive and give a bit more energy to this last moment of the event. So Fabio, if you could be so kind, you have been very active and helpful.
One question for Enrica. For the presentation, I understood that really you have a lot of activity in parallel. One is the change management, expect then the lean and the quality, no? Management. And the second one is the digitalization. It's important for me to understand the percentage of difficulty between the change manager with respect to the digital transformation.
Difficult to distinguish because they are strongly integrated. Consider that in Whirlpool, in particular way, we started 3 years ago to develop a maturity assessment approach that is supporting us in the introduction of these new technologies, so in supporting the digital transformation. Because we experienced that once we introduce a technology for which we are not ready, the sustainability phase immediately. So after 6 months that you launch the project, this is not working or providing or giving the expected result. And so this means that the digital maturity assessment and the change management is a structured action supporting with communication and training the areas where we work with introducing the new technologies is something that goes with the digital transformation. So the roadmap is unique, is integrated. It's not if one I, more important if, than others. So one
if I may, another,
without the other.
I'm sorry, Riga. If I may, another point, in which percentage the quality is increased and in which percentage is linked to change management respect the digital transformation?
What do you mean the quality increased?
But the number of the decreasing of defect or the escape that you find on the line.
Ah, okay. But consider that within the digital transformation, with the focus of quality, the action we did the digital within the digital transformation roadmap are several. So in particular way, in our industry, relevant and the higher and the Electrolux are here, so we can say the same, I think. Passed through the data analytics and vision system. So the possibility to have an automatical identification of the defect related to that of quality. And we started years ago on this direction. For what concerns the digital assistance is something that is pretty new for us. We had some trials failing due to the fact that we have not done a proper change management and we were not ready to introduce it. That's the reason why the result in terms of quality improvement for this type, for the digital assistance introduction, were not the expected one. That's the reason why we are now working, having a step back, working in this type of experience like the research project in order to explore all the aspects, also the organizational and cultural aspects that are around the introduction of this type of element in order to properly set up a change management. While for example, the more consolidated technology like vision system, light automatically defect identification and so on, is something that has already been done. And the result there are relevant, are important. I don't know if I answered to your questions.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, thanks a lot. Just for guys not to think that we have only Italians here on board, we have, of course, it's mainly for South Europe companies as the biggest part of the event, but we have now people from, we have one participant from Russia, if I can see her, and one from US. Ayan from Suez, US. Ayan, no question if you are still with us. Ayan Predi, are you with us?
I am. Hi, good afternoon. I think the question I was trying to formulate in my head was around the training piece. And I run a manufacturing floor with pretty complex processes. What was the return or the benefit from using Qualia versus traditional training methods?
The difference is that versus the trend, for example, we experienced also some virtual reality or augmented reality system supporting the training. The difference with Qualia is that Qualia has an AI engine embedded that first of all learn how to communicate effectively with that specific individual. So this means that it's not only a matter of multi-language, but it's also a matter of how to communicate, how this person, which type of language, which type of experience this person has, if he using acronyms or something else. So there is a continuous fine tuning of the communication in order to improve the user experience. This is one element. The second one is that the Koala is able and has to be able to provide, to accumulate the knowledge by the experience of that user and by all the others in order to create a recommendation that may support and speed up the learning phase.
Okay.
This is the difference. And consider that in the case of Piacenza and Diversity is a detergent industrial company, while Fratelli Piacenza is a textile. So they have complex machineries that needs weeks of training before having a complete a full and sure secure introduction of the person in the production flow. And so this means that for 3 weeks, 4 weeks, they have a supervisor that have to support that specific individual in order to complete the training path. Having a digital assistant means that we can reduce these 3 weeks to 1 week.
Oh, wow.
And 1 week is a lot.
Yeah, we are the same. We have months of training. So yeah. This would be an opportunity.
For Whirlpool, the quality control is something that can be done only by really very experienced people currently. So this means that we need to have at least 3 months, 4 months of experienced people in order to have an operator that is ready to have a check, because it's a 360 degrees check on that product. He has to verify everything, each single component, each single functionality. In our idea, with the Koala operator will be able to complete the checklist in 1 week, 10 days at maximum. Not only, but with the quality, a level of quality in the execution of the task, and so in the final result that is absolutely much better than the current one.
Oh, that's interesting. Did it also raise the level of standards, so you don't train and then the level drops, and then do they continue to use the Koala tool in after they've been trained as a yes. general practice?
In our case, yes. In the Piacenza diversity training, so in the training on the job use case, no, because the focus is to leave the operators when they are ready, because the focus there is really to create a training for the operators. And the idea for them is to have this training online and active again every time that there is a change in the production flow. For example, when a new product is introduced or a change in the machinery is introduced, or the person is moved in another workplace. While for a Whirlpool use case, the usage of Koala will be continuous, because for every product, the predictive quality predictive capability of Koala may support with recommendation, with active recommendation.
Okay, thank you. Appreciate it. I might connect with you later.
Welcome.
Thanks a lot. Though this is the last presentation of today, I know you are tired, but because she's waiting for us and I gave her the latest time, so still we give her some more time to Enrica for questions. Let me see if colleagues from Electrolux have any question or higher.
I think that they have the same problem that we have.
Nicola Marino, coming late, no question.
Hi, Claudio speaking from Electrolux.
Yeah. Go ahead, thanks.
I know it was very interesting, and we have something similar. And of course, it helps for sure also from my experience, because I've been working for 11 years in the quality department, so the shop floor. So I know.
You know perfectly.
Yeah, I know this kind of stuff, and especially regarding what is the end of line check. Statistical check and how to go through all the different features for the different models. So this is a kind of solution of digital solution that is supporting and telling step by step what to do is definitely something that we implemented years ago, and it works. It definitely works because it's also, let's say, keeping people updated. We have also a sort of connection through a digital system. From if something is found in the end of the line, there is a quick digital link to the team leader in the assembly area to say, hey, there's a problem. So raise up immediately, because in this case, the let's say tempestivity, and the quicker you are, the more dead you do in terms of not try first time or whatever. So I see that, Erika, we understand each other.
Yes. Very well. Absolutely, yes.
Yeah,
so the key element, the novelty that is introduced here is really the fact that the AI support both the communication and the predictive. Exactly. The predictive is an important element.
And it's
currently
also
we are not able to address.
And it's also important because in our system then we have also integrated the data collection of, let's say, what are the faults, because then also addressing the faults and naming the faults is quite a story, no? Because it's not simple. There are different codes that are also then linked to the service. But it helps also in putting data together and understanding variation, linking to what we can find in the market. And so definitely a good approach if we compare to the old checklist in paper version we had in 2005 when I joined the quality department. This is a step ahead,
it's another generation.
Definitely. And also it also allows, for instance, to embed special checklist that maybe can be asked by key account
customers,
exactly, on top of, so we can say also put these things inside this kind of system. So nice to see that someone had the same idea.
But I think that is something very common. I think that IR will have the same
for sure we come from, we have seen a really transformation that is impressive, I think, no? And actually I'm happy to have joined in the late 90s the company, because I have seen before lean and also before digitalization. And so if you just jump in our company today, you don't perceive how the hell it changed the story. And so this is really, really remarkable, I would say.
For us, I have to say that in particular way, the challenge is, and we are working a lot on the digital assistance technology. We are strongly believing and trusting the validity of this type of technology to be introduced at show floor, like really something that will change the life of the But really the trial experience, like has been mentioned in the last coffee conversation. So the introduction of the trial experience, like cherry picking, that are not integrated into a structured and standard vision is something that fortunately face after months or a few months or a few years. In the best solution. And on the contrary, the digital assistance and the chatbot that, for example, we tested till now is not something that created the confidence of the workers. So as to be the quality of the chatbot, and in particular way, what concerns the communication and the perception of the effectiveness of the solution is something that we have to address. So I don't know if you have already addressed it, but I think that really this is something that is challenging. Because the question is that, okay, it's a nice game, but I don't.
One topic is still explaining in a very quick and effective way, let's say effective way, workstation by workstation, what to do, because we have also digital solutions there. But for sure, it is the next step, because if you think of a piece of paper, A4, with written instruction, put somewhere it is something from it would be called classics.